Shakespeare. English poet and playwright, Shakespeare is widely considered to be one of the greatest, if not the greatest, writer in the English language. He wrote 37 plays and 154 sonnets. He was also known as the Bard of Avon and often called England's national poet. Born in Stratford-upon-Avon in England on the 23rd of April 1564, he was an important member of the Lord Chamberlain's Men Company of theatrical players from roughly 1594 onward. By 1597, Shakespeare had already written and published 15 of his 37 plays, and by 1599, William Shakespeare and his business partners built their own theatre on the south bank of the Thames River. Tradition has it that William Shakespeare died on his 52nd birthday, on April the 23rd, 1616. And each year, on April the 23rd, we celebrate Shakespeare Day. Shakespeare's reputation as a dramatic genius wasn't recognized until the 19th century. In the 20th century, new movements in scholarship and performance have rediscovered and adopted his works. Today, his plays are highly popular and constantly studied and reinterpreted in performances with diverse cultural and political contexts. The genius of Shakespeare's characters and plots are that they present real human beings in a wide range of emotions and conflicts that transcend their origins in Elizabethan England.
Did you guys like it? Someone pray.
We have a project on Shakespeare. Would you like to see it?
Yeah, sure.
But first of all, I will do a recital on Sonnet 3.
Okay.
Sonnet 3. Look in thy glass and there the face thou viewest. Now is the time that face should fall under me, whose fresh repair is now thou that renewest. Thou dost beguile the world and bless some body. For where is she so fair who sent thee and whom disdains the tillage of thy husbandry? Or who is he so fond will be the doom of his sad love to stop posterity? Thou art thy mother's loss, and she in thee calls back the lovely appeal of her crime. So thou who windows of thine age shalt see, despite of wrinkles, this thy golden time. But if thou live, remember not to be, dies in the earth and thine image dies with thee.
That's it.
Thank you, Lizzie. So, okay, here's a project I've been working on. Lily, what can you see in this picture?
Oh, they are the same red.
Okay, and Lisha? In this one, he looks younger and here he looks older.
Yes, you are right. Actually, while Shakespeare was writing this poem, he wanted to focus on the youth who has to take the decision of procreating or not. And here in this mirror, you can see that this old man has his own reflection in it, and maybe, probably, he is regretting now that he did not procreate earlier while he had time to do so.
Okay, and here I've got my response to it. I've kind of had to create one, and I will read it for you.
Sure.
So, come closer to thy gloss of yours. Now has come thy time to take a decision of getting opportunities and opening doors to escape from that tiresome situation. The choice belongs only to you, to be either a machine of reproduction or have a different point of view. Make your voice heard for next generations. Enjoying thy status of being single is a choice of me, and never an act of selfishness. Your father opens thy window of remembrance to see his own reflection when he was young and homeless. The choice is yours, live and die alone, or reproduce so as next generation look like your clown.
Thank you, Lily, for sharing that with us.
You're welcome, Nisha.
Oh, here comes Anna.
Hey guys!
Hi, Anna!
What are you doing?
We are sharing our favorite Shakespeare sonnets.
Really? Which
yes.
One's your favorite?
So mine is 103.
Mine is 102.
And mine is 115.
Oh, the lovey-dovey one. Mine is 130.
You have it with you?
Yes, it's on my phone actually. I was just reading it. Do you want me to read it for you?
Yes, sure.
So it goes like this. My mistress's eyes are nothing like the sun. My mistress's eyes are nothing like the sun. Coral is far more red than her lips red. If snow would be white, then why then her breasts are done? If hairs be wired, black wires grow on her head. I have seen roses damask, red and white. But no such roses see I in her cheeks. And in some perfumes is there more delight than in the breath that from my mistress shrieks. I love to hear her speak, yet well I know that music has a far more pleasing sound. I dreamt I never saw a goddess go, my mistress, when she walks, treads on the ground. And yet, by heaven, I think my love as rare as any she will be with false compare.
Thank you for sharing that with us, Anna, but that was so full of insults.
That's very unlike other sonnets, please.
Why do you like this one?
You know, actually, Sonnet 130 shows Shakespeare's style of wit and insult and sarcasm, and that's why I really like it. Because it shows how the man really loves our lady, and not just because of her physical appearance. He loves her instead of all the imperfections that she portrays.
Okay, but I've got a friend who is working on the same project as that family, and she does a very beautiful painting. She's working on the synesthesia. Maybe one day I can invite her and share her painting and do a mislead work for us.
Like other leaves make their way to the pebble shore, so do our meanings hostile to the end. Each changing place is that which goes before, in seeking toil or forward to content. Nativity, once in the main of life, crawls to maturity where we've been grown. Crook the eclipses against his glory fight, and time that gave birth now his gift confound. Time doth practice the perished step of youth, and dares the parallel in beauty's blue. Feeds on the rarities of nature's truth, and nothing stands but for his sight to move. And yet, to times in hope my virtual stand, praising thy love despite his cruel hand. So next 60, this is my personal response to Shakespeare's sonnet. Using the iambic pentameter technique, Shakespeare's sonnet 60 is among famous antique, writing on a curiosity by using the theme of nature and supernatural power to show the passage of time over life. Time never stands still, it moves forward towards its prey to show its presence. It moves forward to exert its upper hand over inferior being, to destroy youth and beauty, to increase anxiety, nervousness, pressure for one's priorities. Tick tock, tick tock, time is moving preciously. Don't watch the clock, do what it does. Keep moving, as you need to control what controls you. And now is my reflection for Sonnet 60. There are no differences between Shakespeare times and our day's time. Time still flies as fast as light. The imagery used by Shakespeare in his Sonnet 60 can be clearly seen in my drawing, showing how time has an upper hand on human beings, either in the form of waves, replacing each other on the beach, or by showing the growth of man in comparison to the birth of the new sun, to its maturity at noon, and hence being captured by the crude eclipse. Just like man struggled throughout his life and thinking that 24 hours a day is not enough. Time is even portrayed as a monster, just like in the painting where the Lord of Death absorbs the sacrifices, achievements, struggles of man till his old age and death, which are bound to happen in the course of time.
Lady Beatrice, have you left all this while?
Yeah, and I will wait a while longer.
I will not decide that.
You have no reason. I do it freely.
Surely I do believe that your fair cousin is wrong.
Ah, it is how much the man is done of me that would make him right.
Is there such friendship?
Yes, but no such friend.
May a man do it?
It is a man's office, not yours.
But Beatrice, I love nothing in the world so much as you. Isn't that strange?
It is as strange as the thing I do not. I love nothing more than you.
By my sword, Beatrice, thou wilt bless me?
Then swear and eat it.
I will swear I love thee, and I will make him eat. That's it.
Did you eat your words?
No, not with any source device for it. I protest and love thee. Why then, God forgive me?
For what offense, Beatrice? He has stayed with me in happy moments.
I was about to protest my loyalty.
And do it with all my heart. I love you so much from my heart that none is left to protest.
Come, bid me to anything for me. Kill
Claudius. Ha! No.
You kill me singly? Farewell.
Terrorist Beatrice. Farewell, Beatrice.